Hello YouTubers, today I got another PlayStation 4 broken HDMI port, most common issue on these game consoles. As you can see, that port is totally destroyed. Bent. Most common issue. So we're gonna fix it. So I'm gonna disassemble it. Be back. So we got the whole game console apart. Got it down to the board. So what we're gonna do is clean this whole thermal paste off. So it's clean later when we put it back together. Make sure you take out the battery. Don't put it on the machine, that's a lot of voltages. So of course the battery's gotta drop. Now we're gonna want to tape off the RAM chips, obviously. You want to make sure you tape this off with Captain Tape. You're going to have to remove the shield housing. And you want to make sure you don't knock this dial off right here. Tape off the other ports. There you go. you're going to want to tape out these little components here underneath the HDMI port. I guess they just want to make it a little bit more difficult for you to replace the port. If you knock these off out of place, at least they'll still be there under the tape. Look at the crappy soldering job that they did. Looks like a regular person. Alright, so grab our little shield here. Alright, we got it all taped off now. We put it on the machine. Add the brackets. We're going to take this other port off. We're gonna add some flux. Humidity levels are really low, so gonna start the profile. I had to re-put the temp sensor close by. this moment, it's a good idea to get your solder sucker that sucks the solder up all cleaned up. Got about 30 seconds left. it's became melting stage right now. So about like 10 to 15 seconds. You have to be careful sucking the solder out of these pockets because all those other components are by. Stop the profile and let it cool down. Alright, so I got the port off. Board is done cooling. This is the damaged HDMI port. It's pretty damaged. Common issue. So we'll take this off the board. Make sure you want to remove all of this tape carefully. As you can see, there's a couple components that knocked off. A couple dials. So and the speaker thing always usually comes off with the tape. So what we're gonna have to do is remove this other side carefully. Everything's intact there. You always gotta worry about this one getting sucked up. But if you tape it off pretty good, it won't. Question is, why would they do that? Maybe it was too easy for other people to replace the ports. Who knows? So we got those, we got to set those to the side.
lot of tape. You reuse that section for the RAM for another PlayStation 4. Alright, so put the speaker back on. Speakers back on. So now we're gonna have to dress those two dowels that we took off with the tape. Good thing the tape's there. That's why you want to put the tape down, because if you don't put the tape down, those things are gonna go flying off, or you'll never find them. Or you have to take them from a donor board, because unfortunately we don't have schematics for these PlayStation 4s. It would be, or these game consoles, period, you know. Nothing but old game consoles we have schematics for, but it would be nice to have the schematics to repair these devices, especially the PlayStation 4's game consoles. And most likely, you know, PlayStation 4, the company, would not probably replace this port. They would probably send us to landfill or something, you know, and they'll probably give the person a refurnished game console that doesn't have any issues, maybe something with a disk drive that they repaired or something. But it would be nice, like I said, to have the schematics for these, or the access to parts to be able to order, you know, APU, the GPU, whatever it is, video chip, CPU. But it'd be nice, and, you know, it'd be nice to actually get these ports, order them from directly from the company supplier, but we have to order them from China, and hope that we get them in the mail. That's the big thing. So, let's dress these pads real quick. Put some flux down. Turn my ventilation system on. Gonna have to grab them back from the same way. So I'm gonna turn the air down so these things don't go flying around. Change my tip out. Come off. I want to remember the direction it came off. So basically it'll have a line on one side. It's usually the negative. There we go, we got it off careful. Now we come in with the heat. Sure you got a grip of this thing or else it'll go flying. Notice that one pad doesn't have really too much solder on there, so I'm gonna add a little bit. Now we're gonna grab the other one carefully. Obviously this is gonna, you know, pass direction and allow current to pass through one direction, so, you know, obviously the negative side is gonna be on this way, so, you know, power can come through this way and not come back, so. If you did lose the direction of them. And come in, just tack them with the soldering iron. All right, those are back in place. You can see the holes are clean of solder, nothing. So we're gonna dress these pads. Alright, now we clean it up. Get it dressed. For the new port. Now you're gonna have to line it so we need to bend the pins, bottom brace pins, just over a little bit. All right, that should be good enough. Alright, so what we're gonna do is brace it with something. Turn up the airflow. Add some flux. Now, all right, there we go. It's mounted in place. Just hold it there for a second. Let it cool down. And you let up off it. So we got it all in place, flat, as you can see. So now I'm going to add some flux here. Come in with the soldering gun. looks all good. Bridged a couple, but come on, bridge pretty easy. That iron. Alright, looks good. Alright, now we have that done. It's a good idea, don't tack in the port yet in case you have to, you get it really bridged and you have to remove it for any reason. Add some flux. Vortex so much heat, it's crazy. Solder never wants to stick. There we go, finally. Once the board starts grabbing heat, it'll grab the solder. Depending on what kind of type of soldering iron you have. Just clean it up a little bit here. Alright. Remove the rest of this tape. Let's clean it up a little bit. Always make sure you put the battery back in. Alright, so all there is to do is just test it. Got a brand new HDMI port on there. Hope you guys liked the video. Please like, subscribe, appreciate it. Thanks for watching.